Good afternoon, students. My name is Yuna Kario, and I'm your tutor for the subject Learner Development and Learning. And this is for the students that are doing ACP, BES, DES, and DE, that is LDL11. And welcome to the contact sessions for this semester. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what will be in this question paper. The paper is out of 120 marks. It will be 2 hours, 30 minutes long. And there will be 5 questions in these questions, and you are required to answer all the questions. The study material that you will need for this specific module is a study guide. This is the Learner Development and Learning study guide. This is for the ACPE students, BESP student, the DE student, and the DES student, as I've mentioned earlier. Okay, so I'll go through each unit and I'll specify the questions that will come from each and every unit which will be in this exam. In unit 1, as we know that unit 1 is about analyzing the features and factors that influence the development of adolescents. In this unit, I think there are about 3 questions that will come from this unit. The topics to concentrate on in unit 1, which will be in your question 1. You should know the meaning of the terms maturity, heredity, and bilingualism. Okay, before I move on to the next point, let's quickly discuss what we mean by maturity, heredity, and bilingualism. Okay, when you talk about maturity, we say it is the process of learning to cope and react in an emotional appropriate way. So when someone is said to be matured, they have learned how to cope and how to react in an appropriate way at their age. Okay, maturity also involves a situation whereby a person can deal with at a young age, and they can be prepared for the next age, and in this case, for adulthood. Maturation does not stop when physical growth ends; it continues throughout adulthood. And you should also know that when you talk about maturation, we mean that an adult who loses a parent, for instance, learns to cope with a new emotional situation that will affect the way he or she deals with situations that follow. So all these are all aspects of maturation. So when you are discussing the issue of maturation, please, it's a discussion which will actually earn you 5 points. So please try to discuss it further. It's not enough to only give the definition of the term maturation, but you should discuss it more. And then we have the term heredity. You are required to define what is meant by heredity and discuss in a few sentences what is meant by heredity. Heredity, as we know it, it refers to the natural process by which physical and mental qualities are passed on from a parent to a child. Heredity does not only refer to rigid, fixed behavior, but instead it also looks at possible developmental outcomes that may happen in response to the environment in which a person is growing in. Heredity is also passed on, or is able to be passed on, from child, from parent to child at birth. And sometimes heredity trends or diseases can also be passed on from a parent to a child. That is what you need to discuss when you talk about heredity. And then we have bilingualism. You need to discuss what is meant by bilingualism. Give examples of when a person is said to be bilingual. Bilingual speakers sometimes learn their own language simultaneously with another language. For example, someone who is born in an environment where they speak Oshikwanyama, and then at the same time the person learns English. So we can say they are bilingual, and because they are learning the same two languages at the same time. That is what you need to discuss in terms of bilingualism. Still in Unit 1, we will have a question on the effects of alcohol and drug abuse on the developmental domains of learners. This question will require you to discuss how alcohol and drug abuse affect learners' developmental domains. How does it affect them? So you need to discuss more on what happens when there's alcohol and drug abuse in the situation. Okay, and then we'll look at the physically abused learners. We will need to, in this question, you are required actually to discuss what the teacher should look out for when a learner is physically abused. What are the symptoms? What are the signs that this child is physically abused? As a teacher, how can you identify that the child in your classroom has gone through physical abuse? That is what you are required to do. Okay, now we're going to Unit 2. Okay, Unit 2 looks at the theories of the adolescent development. Here we are looking at the theories. In this case, we are going to concentrate on the theory of Piaget, and you will need to make a comparison of Piaget's concrete operational stage and the formal operational stage of development in children. Let me repeat it again. As it stands in your slides, it says that you must make a comparison of Piaget's concrete operational stage and the formal operation stage of development in children. As we know that Piaget has got about 5 stages, but in this case, I only concentrated on 2 of his stages, which is the operational and the formal operational stage. So you need to discuss what happens, what happens in the concrete operational stage, which does not happen in the formal operational stage, and what happens in the formal operational stage, which does not happen in the concrete operational stage. That's what you need to discuss there. So under Unit 2, you also have a question on temperament and its characteristics. In this case, you have to discuss what is meant by temperament. And then temperament has got 9 characteristics as it stands there in your study guides. So please name them and then discuss them briefly. That's what this question will require you to do. And that is about a question that is worth 15 marks. So please spend some time discussing what is meant by temperament. For example, discuss issues such as temperament differs from personality, even though it is related. Discuss that temperament is present at birth, but it's difficult to determine it at around the age of 4 months until the babies have grown more physically. You need also to discuss that temperament differs, like I said, from personality, but it's rooted in the biology of the child. Yeah, we need to discuss all that. And under the characteristics of temperament, we have got sensory threshold as one of them, activity level, intensity, adaptability, mood, and so on. So please, I'm not going to mention all of them here. You have them in your study guides, but please go through them, study them, and prepare well, and you should be able to name all 9 of them and briefly discuss them, as I've just mentioned. That's what Unit 2 that's what you need to concentrate on in Unit 2. Now we go on to Unit 3, which of course will be your question 3. In Unit 3 is about the learning aspects and the learning theories. Okay, so under this unit, the first question, it will be worth 15 marks, and then you are going to discuss the learning styles. We know about the visual learning style and the auditory learning style and the kinesthetic learning styles. These are the learning styles that you have to discuss. Each learning style, as it stands there, it will be worth 5 marks. So if you discuss the visual learning style, it's worth 5 marks. Under visual learning style, we know we talk about learners that think in pictures and they learn based in visual images. That's what we have to discuss here. Please give examples. Give examples where possible, if in your own learning situations. We talk about the auditory learning styles. These individual learners discuss information through listening and through interpreting by means of pitch or emphasis or speed. These are the learners that gain knowledge from reading out loud in the classroom, and they may have a full understanding of information that is written. That is the auditory learning styles. And then the last one is the kinesthetic learning styles, whereby learners learn best with an active hands-on approach. Yeah, please give an example where you have a situation where learners learn best on using the hands-on approach. These learners favor interaction with the physical world, and they can easily get distracted. This is what you need to discuss under question 3.1 in question 3. Okay, and then the next line under unit 3 there in your slides, it says the relevance of understanding the long-term memory and the short-term memory in the learning process. As a teacher, you know you are required to understand how the long-term memory and short-term memory differ and how they are important. Each of them are very important for the learning process. So how do they help us understand information? And as a teacher, how can you use them in terms of storage of information, and how the learners can learn best using both their long-term memory and short-term memory? So you need to understand, why is it important? What is it relevant for us to understand long-term memory and short-term memory as teachers? That is what we have under Unit 3, which is, of course, Question 3. Now we move on to Question 4, which is under Unit 4. Okay, and Unit 4 is about self-concept issues as part of human development. Under this unit, we have factors that influence people's self-esteem. We have got discipline styles. These are the questions that will come under the question four questions. Okay, the first one, as I said, the factors are that influence people's self-esteem. Okay, so discuss these factors and how they influence people's learning. So please go through Unit 4 and go through all the factors that are given to you there, which may influence people's self-esteem. For example, the reaction of others. This is one of the factors that can influence how people view their own self-esteem, how they carry themselves, and how their own positive self-image is affected. We have got comparison with others. We know it's a fact that as human beings, we have a tendency to compare our own achievements with other people's achievements, our own failures. We measure them to other people's failures. Also, this comparison with others is one of the factors that are under the factors that influence people's self-esteem. Please, under these major factors, please discuss with examples. Of course, it will earn you more marks. This question is going to be worth 12 marks. It's going to be out of 12 marks. We've got social roles. The role that you carry as yourself, are you as a teacher, as a parent, as a community member, for example, how does it affect your self-esteem in society? And then we've got identification as the other factor. So you have to, for example, it says the part of our personality, for example, we identify with the positions that we occupy. Do you only identify yourself as a teacher, or do you only identify yourself as a mother or as a member of the community? That's identification. So these are the other factors that can also influence people's self-esteem. Okay, then we go on to discipline styles. We know we have got many discipline styles that we have. We've got the authoritarian discipline style. We have got the authoritarian. We have got the other types of, I'm not going to mention all of them. Please go through all the discipline styles that we have. I'm not sure, I know there are not so many. So please go through them. I'm not going to mention all of them. I've just got an example of the authoritarian discipline style, but it's not the only one that I've asked. I think I've asked in this question paper, there will be two discipline styles that will be asked. Please go through them. I've just given you one of them is the authoritarian learning style. You can look at the others also, which are also discussed there in your study guide under Unit 4. Like I said, there are many of them. Okay, now we go on to the last question, which is question 5. Question 5 is also, it's coming under Unit 5. Okay, Unit 5 is the features of development of self-directed learning and thinking styles. That is what we have in Unit 5. In this unit, you are required to actually explain how developing proper studying and learning styles is possible for learners. How can our learners develop proper studying and learning styles or learning habits? Use the 13 study habits in your explanation. And these 13 study habits are explained thoroughly in your study guides. Use them in your explanation on how learners can develop proper study and learning habits. This is what you are required to do in question 5. Yes, and I think that is the end of our presentation. Please before I end off this presentation on our subject, LDL, as students, you are required, please, to take in mind that your spellings, the way you are writing, please plan before you write and try as much as possible to answer what the question is requiring you to write. For example, if you have a question which says, what is meant by maturation? You shouldn't start off this question by giving examples of what is examples of maturation. You should start off by saying maturation, what does it mean? You have to explain thoroughly what is meant by the term maturation. That is what you are required to do. You are required actually to answer the questions, and please, as you are answering your question, take in mind that you have the marks allocated in mind. Look at the marks allocated. If the question requires you to give 5 points and the question is asking you to give the meaning of the word maturation, you are supposed actually to look at the fact that one sentence of course will not earn you the whole 5 marks. You need to further explain more on the meaning of maturation, and the same goes on also for the questions. Like I said, as I was going through this questions, I mentioned that there are some questions that will be worth 15 marks, some questions will be out of 20 marks. I think my longest question is going to cost you 16 marks, and that's the last question on question 5, which is about developing proper studying and learning habits. Of course, under such a question, we know that it will require you to give an essay kind of answer whereby you are discussing, and then you are giving examples in your discussion, taking into consideration the fact that your spellings can affect the marks that you are going to get at the end of the day. Your spellings, try to make sure that you are writing accurate spellings, because it will not really portray the meaning that you are intending to portray if the word you are writing is very far from the actual word that you are intending to write. Yeah, that is all. And please try to plan your time such that you are able to finish the exams within the given amount of time that you are writing the exams. This exam is 2 hours, 30 minutes, so it is enough time for you to finish these questions. They are not so long questions, and there are not so many questions at the end of the day. So, yeah, good luck with your exams, and please feel free to call me. My number is 081-2851424. And I'm sure some of you already have my number. For those of you who are taking this subject for the first time, my name is Ms. Kario, and I am your tutor for the subject LDL. And yeah, my cell phone number again is 081-2851424. You are free to call me and ask for clarity for any of the points that I mentioned in this these slides. And you have the slides with you, so please prepare well for the exams, and good luck with exams. Thank you.